Hey Tim, I got your email and you mentioned about World War II and the French and the way they treat the Germans having its roots in World War I, hence the eventual German retaliation against the French and Hitler giving rise after the Kaiser had his way. I wanted to mention that although my dad didn't have any particularly memorable French stories that I recall. I should send you a copy of his Letters from World War II book. We had a neighbor in Syracuse, John Lindovski, and he and his wife were the best neighbors you could ever want. They were friendly. The wife would let Aurora into the house, and she would give her little gifts sometimes, and John would be in his backyard, and he was an old guy, but when we first moved there, he would still putter around the house, and he would have a beer every now and then. As he got older, he was less able to do this, and eventually his brother came over and started helping him around the house. But after we had been there a number of years, he told us a story about when he was in World War II. And he was stationed in France, and he was only 16, I think it was, maybe 15 or something, but he lied about his age because he wanted to help in the war effort. So he finally got some, I don't know if you would call it shore time, I guess you'd have to call it leave time. He finally got some leave time, and him and his friends went into town. They got drunk, they did who knows what, and they got arrested, and they wound up in the local, you know, police headquarters jail. And they wanted to make a phone call to contact their CO, you know, the sarge, the barracks officer, I don't know. So the French allow them to make the call, and they tell, you know, tell the sergeant, we're drinking, we got arrested, I guess we did some dumb stuff, and the sergeant says, okay, let me talk to the cops again. Get on with the cops, and turns out they don't let him go. So eventually, when they get out of there, he asks the sergeant, what did you say, you know, to the cop? He wouldn't let us go, and the sergeant says, I told him to keep you there. I told him to keep you there until you learn some kind of a lesson. So yeah, that was like a fun story, you know. No blood, no guts, humor. Some of the best stories are grounded in that.